We're here to show an alternate use case for blockchain where we can store electronic medical record on the blockchain. There's three participants in this business network. We have a doctor, we have a pharmacist, and an insurance company, each acting and each having their own instance of the ledger. And we're going to be following the typical life cycle for a given prescription from the moment it's prescribed to the moment that it's been approved by the insurance company.
So our demo today is going to follow the story of John Doe. John Doe hasn't been feeling very well lately, so he goes to his doctor. And as soon as he goes to the doctor, they start putting sensors on him. So heart rate, blood pressure, temperature, all of that stuff. But these sensors that this doctor's using are a little bit different from normal sensors because they're connected to the cloud. So John Doe is able to trust that all of the records that are being kept for him are complete and accurate, meaning he can get a better level of care. So when the doctor comes in, the doctor immediately is able to see that John Doe's heart rate is a little bit crazy. It's very irregular. So the doctor is able to pull up his prescription console. So he's able to find John Doe's medical records and give him a new prescription to hopefully help his heart rate stabilize a little bit. And we'll set the prescription date for relatively soon. Prescription submitted. And so we're able to see that we have a brand new record in our blockchain.
If we go back to the prescription ledger, we can see each transaction that has been added. And we'll see a new prescription was added with the current timestamp. And we'll see the status of it was prescribed.
The pharmacist is also able to pull up the record because she also is able to see the same blockchain ledger as the doctor. She's able to go in and fill the prescription, and we have confirmation the prescription was filled.
So this is what a typical workflow would be like for a good patient, a good doctor, and a good pharmacist. Let's showcase what might happen if the patient was malicious and tried to actually order something like Vicodin. They're gonna go in and log into their machine and run a script or a program that might manipulate that transaction from a beta blocker to Vicodin. And if we go back to the ledger, we'll see that there was an attempt to manipulate that transaction. We can see this because the malicious patient was just trying to manipulate one transaction on the doctor's instance of the ledger. That transaction has been hashed using very advanced cryptography, and we can detect that it is not the same transaction as what's stored on the pharmacist instance or even the insurance instance of the ledger. And that's what creates this distributed ledger between all the participants.
Think about how blockchain now can totally revolutionize the way our medical system works. We're introducing a completely safe, trusted network between all participants so that doctors are able to trust that their prescriptions are getting filled, and ultimately patients are able to get better care. Thank you.